One will be presented with his plaque by Hall of Fame board member Ricky Smith.
Thank you so much. I want to thank the board of directors and the selection committee. I want to congratulate all the other inductees. I want to especially congratulate Mr. Crowder, Dunn's family. Mr. Dunn was my Sunday school teacher at First Baptist Church of Boaz. I guess when I was 9, 10, 11 years old, I don't know, but he was one fine man. I also want to congratulate all the former inductees that are here tonight, and I know all of you are very worthy of that and very appreciative. A couple of regrets that I have. My mom, it was made mention of. My dad passed away when I was 17 months old, and there she was with a 17-month-old and a 3-year-old. And we were very poor. But, you know, she made it work for all of us, and things worked out great. My brother and myself both wound up with college degrees. I was able to play ball. I wasn't the greatest one out there, but nobody loved it any more than I did. The folks in coaching that challenge you and make you find out you can do things that you didn't think you could do. When I was a senior, Coach Billy Hudson, who's in this Hall of Fame, was our football coach. And the third game of the year that year, we got upset by Susan Moore. Coach Hudson convinced us and challenged us that we could do better than that. And after about a 6-hour practice on Monday, we beat Albertville for the first time in 21 years that Friday night. I guess we were afraid if we lost again, no telling what would happen to us. And then in basketball, we were so fortunate. Coach Gant and his family moved to Boaz in the summer of 1964, which was prior to my senior year. And he took over a bunch of ragtags who had won 4 games the previous year. And we opened up in very fine fashion by getting beat by Douglas the first game. And DAR and Coach John Kitchens back there humiliated us the second game, and it was Coach Gant's worst loss ever. And after another one of those 6 or 7 hour practices the next week, he convinced us that we were better than we thought we were, and we were afraid to lose very much more. We went on to win 24 games that year and went to the state tournament and placed 4th down there. Coach Gant coming to Boaz was a double whammy for me. He was my basketball coach, and in addition to that, I wound up getting to marry his daughter. 47 years later, we are still together, and I love and cherish every minute of it. If it wasn't for Candy, I wouldn't be anywhere where I am today, for sure, because she has been a rock for me and has pushed me and stood beside me and behind me and stuck a foot up my rear end some of the time, but I deserved it. And we've got 2 lovely children that we're so proud of. They got messed up by me. I was their high school principal. And any of y'all that's been in principaling or either coaching with your kids, it's not fair to them, because they get accused of getting things that if they got anything, they get accused of getting it because your daddy's a principal or whatever. But our daughter, Krista, they couldn't be here tonight. They had a trip scheduled. My grandson's getting to play at Cooperstown in the Baseball Hall of Fame. And it was already scheduled, and they're playing tomorrow. They represent Hoover, Alabama, and we're thrilled for them. Hate they couldn't be here, but her and her husband Andy and our grandson Raiden and our granddaughter Anna Kay, and then my son Casey and his lovely wife Lauren, they're going to be presenting us our next grandchild in September, and we're so proud of that. And Candy's brother, Dan, and his wife, Susan, are here, and I want to thank them so much. And some of the most special friends anybody could ever have are sitting back there. And we all sort of grew up together, and we double dated and triple dated and whatever else you could do. None of us had any money or anything, but we loved each other and cared about each other. And to this day, we don't see each other as often as we should, but we know if we need something, we can call on. But that's Haskell and Deanna Ashley and Jim and Jane Bishop there. And one of the most special friends that I have anywhere, Mr. Dan Washington, who served honorably as the Alabama High School Athletic Director, Alabama High School Athletic Association Executive Director, for 17 years, I got to serve alongside him on his board. And he taught me so much and did so much for me. And he presented it to us, and we put all the football playoffs in Birmingham at that time, and then later to Alabama and Auburn on a rotating basis. And boys and girls basketball, which hadn't been heard of in any state in the United States, all came together in Birmingham and playing all the state championships right there together. And that is the most successful thing for girls and boys basketball and all the sports, baseball and golf, tennis and track and everything. It really blossomed under Mr. Washburn. And his wife, Shirlene, is such a special friend. We're both lucky we're probably here, because several years ago, we were at the national meeting with the High School Athletic Association, and he and I and our two wives, Candy and Shirlene, were walking around, and we were over by the Capitol in Washington. And Candy and Shirlene, we couldn't get them to listen to us. And they messed around and got up too close to the Capitol. And the Capitol police like to put them and us in jail that night. So thank goodness we're still here. But in my coaching career, you have folks that are so special to you, your players. And tonight there's three of them that are back there, and I appreciate them being here, and I love them so much. Ed Litt, Todd Means, and Billy Holmes, that played for me at Glencoe High School. And we had to have one of those same sessions one time that Coach Hudson and Coach Gant challenged us on, and it worked for them too. And we taught them how to hustle one afternoon in practice. But thank you again so much. There's nobody here any prouder than I am, and the more appreciative. And there's an old quote that life is full of choices, and you are what you choose to be. And I am so glad that I chose to be in athletics, both coaching and principaling, and to be able to see the Todd Means and Billy Holmes and Ed Litz come back and support you and all the other people. But thank you so much, and appreciate you very much.